Could I have your attention, please? Good evening, everyone. We'll call this meeting to order. It's the Wednesday, November 4th special call meeting for swearing in of the new council. The invocation tonight is by Chancellor Elder Chauncey Brown. Ms. Chauncey Brown, are you here? Could you all please rise? Now we have the national anthem by Ms. Loretta Marciano. The Pledge of Allegiance, hold on, Honor Guard. We'll have the Pledge of Allegiance led by the Mayor's Youth Council.
pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. Roll call, Madam Clerk.
Councilman Maldonado.
Here.
Councilman Burgess.
Here.
Councilwoman Fairclough.
Here.
Councilman Williams.
Omnipresent.
Vice Mayor Shelley.
Here.
Mayor Porter.
Here. Tab 1 is a certification of the general election and October 6th primary election. Mr. Attorney?
Mr. Mayor, at your direction, I'm going to read the entire resolution.
Thank you, sir.
Certification of the City Clerk of the City of Homestead, Miami-Dade County, Florida, concerning the canvassing of returns of the primary election of October 6, 2015, and the general election of November 3, 2015, certifying results thereof. Whereas a primary election was held in and for the City of Homestead on October 6, 2015, for the purpose of electing a mayor and one council member in accordance with the charter of the city. Whereas the general election was held in and for the City of Homestead on November 3, 2015, for the purpose of electing one council member, with one other council member having been selected by operation of law without opposition, mayor having been elected at the primary election by receiving more than 50% plus one of the votes cast, and one other council member having been elected at the primary election by receiving more than 50% plus one of the votes cast, and determining the vice mayor designation in accordance with the city charters. And whereas the elections were duly held and returns have been made in accordance with Section 1010 of the Code of the City of Homestead, and returns having been certified by the Miami-Dade County Canvassing Board and the Elections Department, now therefore be it certified by the City Clerk of the City of Homestead, Florida, as follows. Section 1, that the return sheets for the primary election held in the City of Homestead on Tuesday, October 6th, and the general election held in the City of Homestead on Tuesday, November 3rd, be certified as correct by the City Clerk and are hereby filed with the City Council, and the results of the election are as follows. Vice Mayor Patricia Faircloth, 1,434 votes. Larry Mino, 408 votes. Council, general election, John Burgess, 1,373 votes. Larry Mino, 468 votes. Mayor, primary election, Stephen McDuffie, 178 votes. Ramiro Orta, 261 votes. Jeffrey D. Porter, 1,236 votes. Council, primary election, Larry Roth, 970 votes. Mervyn Waldman, 413 votes. Willie Womble, 284 votes. Council, Patricia Faircloth, unopposed, seat number 6. On that basis of the above returns, the following candidates are declared elected to office in the City of Homestead as follows. Mayor, Jeff Porter, to serve a 2-year term. Vice Mayor Patricia Faircloth, Vice Mayor designation for a 2-year term. Council, John A. Burgess to serve a 4-year term, Patricia Faircloth to serve a 4-year term, Larry Roth to serve a 4-year term. That the above-named officials shall take and hold their respective offices upon taking their oaths of office as provided for in the Charter and the Code of the City this fourth day of September of November 2015. Elizabeth Sewell, MPA, MMC, City Clerk, and that is it.
Do you need a motion to accept this? Is there a motion to accept it? Is there a second?
Second.
Moving to seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Obviously, no one's opposed. Thank you, sir. Appreciate that. Before we do the sign and die, I'd like to thank Pastor Brown for the invocation, and we forgot to recognize the Homestead Police Department Honor Guard. They always represent us so well in all different venues. And also, you know, Ms. Marciano for the national anthem. That was a really beautiful rendition. So at this time, we'll go to sine die. All council members will remove from the dais.
Mr. Mayor, the next item on the agenda is the oath of office administered by Nicholas Sincor, administered to Jeffrey Porter, Mayor. Mr. Sincor?
Once again, it's my pleasure to stand before you and swear in my son-in-law, Mayor Jeff Porter, for another term. We're so very proud of him. In fact, the other night, his mother said, "I'm so proud of my son, and if his father were living, he would be proud too," and I'm sure he is proud. Jeff, we're all proud of you. And Jeff. And I'm honored that you chose me to swear you in again. Thank you, Cindy, for doing that for me. Joke. Jeff, repeat after me, please. I do solemnly swear or affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the state of Florida, and will obey the laws of the United States and of the state of Florida, and that I will in all respects observe the provisions of the charter and ordinance of the city of Homestead, and will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of mayor on which I'm about to enter, so help me God. As the authority invested in me in the state of Florida, I now pronounce you again mayor of the city of Homestead. Congratulations.
Mayor Porter, this is the only time I get to tell you what to do, so please take your seat. I'm talking about this seat. The next one is administered by Carlos Brown, administered to Patricia Faircloth, Vice Mayor, in Council Seat Number 6.
I am honored to stand here before you to present to you all my little sister. I, state your name, do solemnly swear or affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the state of Florida, and will obey the laws of the United States and the state of Florida, that I will in all respects Observe the provisions of the Charter and ordinances of the City of Homestead and will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of Vice Mayor and Councilwoman, on which I am about to enter. So help me God.
Vice Mayor Faircloth, please take your seat. Love doing that. Okay. Next is Sherelle Burgess and John Russell, J.R. Burgess, administering the oath to John A. Burgess, council seat number 2.
Okay, we're a little excited and a little nervous. We'll do our best, but congratulations.
I, John A. Burgess, do solemnly swear or affirm that I support the Constitution of the United States and State of Florida, and will obey the laws of the United States and the State of Florida. That I will, in all respects, observe the provisions of the Charter and ordinances of the City of Homestead. And will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of councilman, on which I am about to enter. So help me God.
John A. Burgess, take your seat. The next swearing-in will be done by Alyssa McFerrin, administered to Larry Roth, council seat number 3.
I am very honored and excited to be doing this. Please repeat after me. I, state your name, do solemnly swear or affirm that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the State of Florida and will obey the laws of the United States and of the State of Florida, that I will, in all respects, observe the provisions of the Charter and the ordinance of the City of Homestead, and will faithfully discharge the duties of the office of councilman, on which I am about to enter. So help me God.
Will the remaining council members please join the new council members on the podium?
Hello, Steve. Got a new neighbor over here. Welcome to the neighborhood.
I'm going to ask the council members if they'd like to say anything. I'll start with Vice Mayor Faircloth. How do you like the ring to that?
I'm getting used to it, but I have to start it off. I will do so, though. First, I'd like to thank God, who is the author and finisher of my faith, and the one that has consistently showed me grace. Thank you. He has consistently showed me grace, particularly throughout the course of this race. Without him, none of this would have been possible. To the community, thank you for your unwavering support, your faith and belief in me to effectively serve as your councilwoman and now your vice mayor. I vow to continue to serve with honor, integrity, and strength of character. Thank you so much. To my family, I know you're happy this campaign is over because I was like a thief in the night. You barely saw me, but I thank you so much for your love. My mother that is here tonight, my father that is here tonight, my stepmother, my brothers, and all of those who love me, they are here tonight. Thank you so much, and I vow to continue to make you proud. You know, I began this campaign on January 1st, 2015, because I viewed this as a marathon and not a sprint. I vowed to run a campaign that was a first-class campaign focused principally on the issues and what I had to offer the community. But I must say that there were moments that I didn't feel like I can take it a day longer, let alone an hour or minute. But I was fortunate to assemble a campaign team that was truly the wind beneath my wings. They prayed for me, they encouraged me, and they gave me that second wind when I felt that I couldn't go no longer. So Team Patricia, if you're in the house tonight, thank you so much. I love you. And it was an honor to work alongside of all of you. I look forward to some more downtime together as we continue to work together in my capacity as vice mayor. To my colleagues, to staff, to the city manager, city attorney, and city clerk, I am grateful for the opportunity to sit alongside of you, let alone to work alongside of you. You have inspired me with your honesty, with your integrity and transparency. And I am happy that our family is back together with the addition of Councilman Roth. Thank you so much for being a part of our family. And I look forward to winning more games alongside all of you.
That's right.
You know, this past week has been rough leading up to Election Day. And I reflect a lot and I pray a lot because I'm a woman of faith. So I asked myself, Patricia, you have a very promising career in education. I am an educator, make no mistake about that. But I asked myself, why do you do this? And I answered, I do this because of, I think she was a six-year-old girl who I saw in the Publix in the bread aisle, and she thought she was whispering, but she said, Mom, that's that girl who's running for president. I said, whoa. I said, not president, I'm running for vice mayor. And she looked a little disappointed, but what really resonated to me was, wow, this young girl from the south side of Homestead is not only running for an office that I never thought I'd run for, but it served as a testament to her that we are warrior women and we can run for president, although I'm not running for president. I told myself I do this because of the young boy that I met at Everglades Preparatory Academy yesterday, who was insisting to come back to my tent and to tell me that he voted for me. And I was so impressed because his mom used it as a teachable moment to engage her children in the beauty of democracy. And building a bench of leaders and students in our community early on and letting them know that elections matter. And it's very important that we get out and vote, even in local elections. But more importantly, I do this and I dedicate this to my mother and several warrior women who have to push past pain and curveballs that life throws their way to rise above it all with grit, grace, and fortitude. Mother, please stand. And I know I'm going to get in trouble for this, but my mother is battling breast cancer. My mother is battling breast cancer and so many women throughout this community. And I wanted her to know that, Mother, I did this for you. I know you couldn't be out on the ground with me like you were 4 years ago, but I know you were there with me in spirit. And anyone else that's battling a debilitating disease as such, rise above with grace, grit, and fortitude. And finally, to my youth council who keeps me hip, who keeps me young at heart, thank you so much for allowing me to lead you, and I look forward to continuously serving as the liaison to the Mayor's Youth Council. In closing, I love Homestead, and I can't wait to begin to serve as your vice mayor. As many would say, oh, the hard work begins tomorrow, I say no, the hard work resumes tomorrow. Because we've been working. Thank you, Homestead. To all of you, all the best.
Councilman Larry Roth.
Same problem. I had the same problem during the debate. Couldn't turn the microphone on. Anyways, hey, thanks for everybody for coming out. This is very exciting for me. We had an awesome four-month run here. We started in July. We made our announcements. Don't get me wrong. We had our ups and downs throughout the campaign. This campaign was run for the citizens of Homestead. This is what my plan was, to represent you, serve you as a servant that I've been for 20 years in the city of Homestead. My heart belongs to you guys. All I want to do is serve. I want to thank a whole lot of people, but I'm not going to take the 45 minutes and go through my whole list that it would take. First, I just want to say, today would have never been possible without my best friend and the love of my life. That's Elisa. She swore me in tonight. When I would say to her, "Do we have to walk today?" she would say yes. It was amazing. She was by my side as I knocked on a thousand plus doors in the city of Homestead, getting to know you folks. And that was important to me because you told me what was important to you. You believed in me, and you put me up here with these fine people. And I'll get to these guys in a few minutes, because I appreciate each and every one of you. I love you, Kitty. You were my rock throughout this whole thing. To my son, Zachary, he's here tonight. Stand up for a minute, Zach. There he is. All I can say to him is thank you for putting up for all the stuff you had to put up with during the campaign. I love you, son. Thank you. To my dad, he's here tonight as well. Dad, you want to stand up? There he is. Thank you, Dad, for teaching me that hard work will always pay off. Thank you very much for that. I also want to thank a whole lot of people. I'm going to do that now. I want to thank Tony Garcia. Tony Garcia believed in me. And in fact, he believed in so much in me, he worried for me. He worried a lot during this campaign, more than I did. Sometimes I'd have to say, "Tony, it'll be okay. It'll be fine. We'll get through this. It'll be okay." For that, Tony, thank you very much. Susan Newman. Susan Newman, I don't know if she's still here. She is here? There she is. She said she had appointments, but I think this was kind of important to her. Thank you, Sue, for being there for me. She always made sure I was where I was supposed to be when I was supposed to be there. And her most important thing to me was, Larry, get out there and mingle. I think her Halloween costume this year was a social butterfly. If you don't know Susan Newman, she's one you need to get on your team. She's a go-getter. Thank you, Sue, for everything you've done for me for the last 20 years. Roger Trujillo, are you here? Stand up for a minute, Roger. Roger, you believed in me. You did things during this campaign I never thought you would come out of you. I don't know where your heart came from and your spirit came from. Brother, I love you. You're a good friend. Thank you for everything you did during the campaign, Roger. Thank you. To all the people who voted for me, thank you for believing in me. My campaign consultant, Emiliano, is he here? He's not here. He's working? Probably. He always told me I was behind in the polls. I finally was on to him. He was always, he guided me through this whole process. He called me last week and asked me, why wasn't I walking? And I said, you know we won, right? We already did this. So thank you, Emiliano. A whole lot of other people. Dana and Mark Pasquarella, I don't know if they're here. Are they here? Oh, they're way back there in the back. Big Pig Barbecue, big fans of mine. I appreciate you guys for everything you did. Melissa Gallego, she's here tonight. Thank you, Melissa. Jan Ornstein, Brock and Joel, Ann Schiffer, Charlie Crumpler, David Lowens, Judy and Mark Constable, Larry Deal, Adelia Martinez, Stephen Lori Losner, Andrea Butler, Margaret Gooding, Matt Choi, Dalgis Trevisio, Sharon Fields, Kim Fricky. Man, my mouth is getting dry. I feel like Rubio up here. Need a glass of water. No, I'm kidding. And I can never forget or never say enough thanks to Bonnie King Moran. Where are you, Bonnie? She's this photographer. She's the photographer for the city. She's great. Thank you for everything you do, Bonnie. I also want to thank my new colleagues, our council and mayor, for their kind words, their words of encouragement, and their words of wisdom as I was going through this process. I look forward to working with each and every one of you as we bring the city forward and make Homestead the best we can make it. To the city manager, city attorney, city clerk, and city staff who I've met already and have welcomed me into the city, thank you all very much. It's been such a professional feeling from you guys. You guys have been outstanding with me, helping me prepare for this moment in time. I really do appreciate all of your help. Thank you very much for that. I look forward to working with all of you for the betterment of Homestead. Please always remember, we are in this together, lifting lives, lifting our citizens, and lifting each other every day. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Burgess.
Thank you, Mayor Porter. First, I want to thank the 1,368 people that believed in me for my third term, because without them, I wouldn't be back up here tonight. So let me start by thanking the community that came out to vote and voted for me. Secondly, behind every man, there's two good women, and I've got two here with me tonight. I've got my mother and my wife, Sherelle, who you met earlier. So thank you to them. Somehow I'm able to talk my mom into coming down every campaign and going out there and hold signs and wear a t-shirt, and she looks at me like, why am I doing this again? But she shows up, so thank you, Mom, for coming down. My wife and my son, of course, they're the ones that make the sacrifice day in and day out for us to be able to sit up here and do these jobs that we do. Because there's many nights that he has a soccer game or a school project or something that I'm not able to help or fill in with that my wife has to pick up the slack. So thank you very much, Sherelle. And to my son, because he's the one that told me I had to run. He said, you need to keep working, and 4 more years is perfect, so go ahead and do it. So without his encouragement, and I think his, and when my wife heard him say that, she was like, oh boy, it's 2-1, I'm going to lose the vote. Because we do have votes in our house, but the democracy doesn't always work out So thank you to you guys, because you guys are the ones that sacrificed the most. To Tony and Nancy Garcia, our best friends, thank you. You, as with Larry, you've worked endlessly. 7 o'clock in the morning, 6:30 in the morning, it didn't matter. My phone was ringing with Tony. 10 o'clock at night, he's still calling me. I think I talked to him a lot more than I spoke to my own wife over the last 30 or 45 days, whatever it was. Once he got done with Larry, he took all that energy, Larry, and brought it over to me and wouldn't leave me alone. So I don't know if I'm happy with you that you won in the primary or not, but congratulations to you too.
Thank you.
Adelia Martinez and her family. I know Adelia's here. Thank you. Adelia was so dedicated to a couple campaigns that her and her husband sat out there on Halloween night with the t-shirts on and said, these are our costumes. So they made sure that everybody in the Northwest saw us. So thank you. Her family came out and held signs and all that. You guys were tremendous. To all of the staff, you know, if it wasn't such a good staff to work for and such a great manager that we have here in the city of Homestead, I certainly would not have wanted to put myself back through. I certainly would not have wanted to put myself back through the scrutiny and some days the aggravation that we all face sitting up here from one end of the dais all the way over to the other. Even the clerk gets it, unfortunately. But to you guys, thank you very much, because although this isn't an easy job or a sought-after job by a lot of people, you guys sure do make it easier and make us look good sitting up here, so thank you. To Richard, thank you. You've always been there with guidance, and your words have helped, and I appreciate them also. To the mayor and the newly elected vice mayor, thank you. You guys allowed me to use you during my, not use you, but allowed you to put out a mailer with your endorsements, and that meant a lot. It showed that we are a team up here that believes in the city of Homestead, and we're moving forward as a unit, and we've done a lot of good things, and we all know that we have a lot more good things to come from us and for us. So thank you to the two of you. To my new colleague, Larry Roth, great job. Anybody that walks 1,000 homes deserves it, and I know you are out there. So job well done. Keep your head high and settle in. I know you'll do a great job for us and all 65,000 residents here in the city. So congratulations. To former Mayor Bell, former Mayor Roscoe Warren, I think I saw him, and I don't know if former Mayor Vice Mayor Lozner are here, but thank you, because it was back in 2003 when I started this process that they all welcomed me into the chambers and made me feel a part of the process. And even though they didn't agree with me most nights, they always listened to me at the podium. And poor James used to have to sit through some of that too, as I argued about different things before I was ever elected. And my buzzer would go off and I'd keep speaking, and Mayor Warren would say, wrap it up, please. And I'd keep speaking and he'd say, okay, wrap it up. But thank you to the three of them, because they encouraged me to keep involved, and I did. And I didn't win in 2005. I lost by 21 votes, but I didn't lose my vision for the city of Homestead and the help that I thought I could bring it. And that's what brings me back here today, is the work that we still have to do here and the work that is going to get done here, as we have moved forward more in the last couple of years than I think in almost the entire century behind us. And we've got a long way to go over the next however many years it's going to be before we get through our revitalization of downtown, but we're well on our way and we've got great things coming. To my other colleagues, thank you. You guys have been great up here. Mr. Maldonado, Mr. Williams, Mr. Shelley, thank you. You guys have always been there and supportive also. So with that, I will say thank you to everybody, especially to my wife and son again. To the mayor, thank you, sir, for being a great leader here in the city of Homestead, and good luck to Vice Mayor Faircloth. I know you're going to do a wonderful job for us. So thank you, everybody.
Mr. Williams.
Thank you so much, Mayor, and to my esteemed colleagues that has been newly elected, Councilman Raw. It's a pleasure to be able to work with you on this level. Councilman Burgess, congratulations again on your third lap around. And so the people had confidence in you three times to vote you back in, and so that should be well noted. to our vice mayor, Ms. Faircloth, a lady of class, elegance, and always know the right things to say at the right time. I'm proud to be able to serve you as you serve us as your vice mayor. And I'm so glad that you're here on this dais to be able to provide that gentle touch that we need up here. Thank you so very much for your sacrifice and undying love for the city. And then to our gracious mayor, Mayor Porter, you've done an exceptional well job, and it's been a huge pleasure to work with you. Though we've had our differences, but we have moved on way past that, and I think that it's an honor to serve with you up here. And I will continue to move and motivate and at the mayor's pleasure of whatever committees that he assigns to work hard to make us all proud. And so, Mayor and your family, you do have gone through a whole lot. And all of you who have ran campaigns, and even some of us who have not been running campaigns have had to endure. But it is to God's grace and mercy that we're here. And so, Mayor, thank you for your exemplary leadership in what you have done and guided this council. To the staff, to the city manager, Mr. Kretzis, and to the city attorney, and to the last three that are up here, that are up in another 2 years, Councilman Shelley and Councilman Maldonado, we have done some great things together here in this city, and I think the work will continue. We've got a great team. I look forward to really serving the wonderful people of Homestead in years to come. So thank you, Mayor, so very much.
Gonna have to get used to this. I'm so used to calling you Vice Mayor Shelley, I'll have to. Councilman Shelley.
That's okay. I still call Councilman Burgess Vice Mayor Burgess when I see him, so it sticks. So, but we now have three, you know, one sitting vice mayor and then two former vice mayors, which goes to show, you know, the dedication that we have in this council and in the community. And so I want to congratulate my colleagues for getting reelected, you know, Councilman Burgess, Vice Mayor Faircloth, and invite and Mayor Porter, and then welcome our new colleague with Councilman Roth here to the dais. And I look forward to continuing to work. The city has a lot of major projects and a lot of big things that we have moving forward. And I think it's a testament to, you know, the success of this council and the leadership of you guys as colleagues. You know, it shows in the votes that were received. You know, more than 70% of the electoral body chose each one of you to come back to your seat. And I think that shows the leadership that you guys have shown over time, as well as the leadership of staff and the leadership of this city and this council in moving the city of Homestead forward and really progressing and taking to the city to the next level, to where we want to see the city move. And I think this is going to be a great council to continue those efforts. And, you know, we got a lot of work left to do. But I think the electoral body chose some great candidates, and I'm happy to have my colleagues return, and I'm happy to serve with Councilman Roth. So I look forward to let's keep moving the city forward and get back to work.
Councilman Maldonado.
Thank you, Mayor. Let me be the first to say I know you guys feel relieved. On this day, you know, I know it's already been 2 years ago we were running our campaigns, and I want to thank everyone that ran up here, Mayor Porter, Larry Roth, congratulations, Vice Mayor PF, that's what I call her, Patricia Faircloth, and John Burgess. Thank you all for sacrificing much of your life for the benefit of this city. Me and my daughters and my family who reside here, who've been here for a very long time, are grateful that you guys chose to run and represent the city for what's best for the city. Very honored and very proud as I look amongst you and know that I'm serving with great colleagues, very intelligent, great looking folks, and you guys work hard. And I know that we're gonna continue to work hard and make a difference in this city. I look forward to continue to work with you for those who were reelected, and for Mr. Roth, he's been here working. He's been in the community, and it's good to see that those who put time in this community show that they truly care for the community and give back to the community. The community responds. They see what you're doing. They see who you are, and they'll support you. So, and that's why you're up here. And so I'm looking forward to working with you. Like we've all said, and we all know, and the reason we're involved is because we love the city. It's a great city, and we have a lot that's happening here, and we are going to do great things for this city. So I'm glad to be up here sitting with you and joining you once again as we move forward and making Homestead great. So congratulations, and God bless you guys. Looking forward to working with you.
I just want to say, first and foremost, thank you for putting this group of people back in these offices, putting these people back in these chairs, because this, obviously, Larry is the new kid on the block, and he's going to fold right in, no questions asked. But, you know, and the Councilman Shelley alluded to it. The election was a mandate for us to continue the path that we've chosen, that we've all agreed to work on it. Because like we said, you know, 70, those numbers are really not achievable in elections. Usually you don't see that kind of percentage swing. I mean, 74, 75, 76, 79, there was a huge turnout of support for the incumbents. So that's huge, and thank you. But I want to do a couple things. I want to say, first and foremost, I want to recognize my wife, Cindy. As John alluded to, this is a very tough job that we do. Late nights, early mornings. You come home, you're tired, you don't want to talk, you're aggravated, you're frustrated, and your wife and your son is recipient of that. And I thank you, Cindy, for putting up with that and letting me do this job and not kicking me out and putting me on the back porch all the time. So I love you for that, and thank you. Thank you. I have my parents down. They just recently moved to North Carolina. They came back to be here for our Seminole Theater grand opening and wanted to be here for the swearing in. And Mom and Ken, I thank you both for taking the time and coming back, and love you and appreciate you. And all your encouragement all those years, obviously, maybe paid off a little bit. Thank you so much for being here. And I've got my father-in-law, Nick, and my mother-in-law, Janet. They're here, and it's Nick's fault because I did all of this, got involved in politics. I started arguing with him years ago, and he said, I'm only one guy. You want to make a difference, you got to jump up and throw your hat in the ring. And so the challenge was on. So, but I really appreciate the advice and all the many years of support from the Syncors, and thank you so much. Appreciate that. We do have a couple of people I'd like to recognize. We have Commissioner Cava down from Miami-Dade County. Thanks for being here, Commissioner. I know Mr. Burgess mentioned Mayor Warren. He's in the back. He's a former mayor, retired. Obviously, my father-in-law is a former mayor. We've got also former Mayor Linda Bell in the office, in the audience. And I want a special little shout out to Frank Bowserbury. He's a really good friend of ours that helps us at Miami-Dade County Mayor's Office. He's a really trooper for us and carries our message forward. Thank you, Frank, for being here so much. And I just want to say a little thank you to Bobby Brown. He was he helped me in this campaign, and we've become very good friends. And I appreciate all your help, Bobby, and hopefully we can do a lot in the future. But we, you know, it's been alluded to that we have challenges. We still have a lot of things to do. The manager and his staff, you really do a great job. You really do a super job for us, and it makes us look good.
And that's a part of why we got the 70% of support from the community, 70-plus percent support for the community, because the actions that we're taking are bold. We talked about this when we went into the election. We're never going to take the foot off the gas. We've got to keep the pedal to the metal, because while we've got the support of the community, we need to go forward and carry out the wishes. We have the support of the community. It's been proven in this election. Keep the foot on the gas, pedal to the metal, and let's continue to perform and provide. We make promises, but we keep those promises. That's the difference. Over the years, a lot of promises have been made. Not always have they been able to be kept. If we say we're going to do something, let's make sure we do it. But you have performed exemplary, you and the staff. I can't ask for anything anymore. But thank you for staying with us. And I know it's a tough job, but that's why you get the big bucks. But to the attorney's office, you know, Richard, you're a, I've talked about it before, you're one of the few people that knows the history of Homestead almost better than anyone. You were here signing documents when we got the racetrack, when we did the Park of Commerce, you know, a lot of really key issues. I think that was a legacy time for Homestead. Those were huge, bold steps that council made. This council is doing as huge and just as bold steps. This is another legacy piece another legacy time in this community where we'll be able to look back and say, this changed everything. Like Homestead Miami Speedway changed everything. Like the Park of Commerce changed everything. This is going to be a snapshot in time. We'll look back and say, this changed everything. So thank you for you and your team, you know, walking us through and keeping us in line and on track. And you know, it's an amazing team that we've assembled, that the public has assembled. And so as we go forward, we want the community to buy into what we're doing, but we're going to have to move fast. Don't let us run away from you. If we get too far out in front, let us know. We'll slow you down. We'll slow it down, catch you up. But that's our charge. We've got Phase 2 of our downtown revitalization. You know, you look at what we've done in less than 2 years. Well, actually 2 years. We got a new city hall getting ready to move into. We just did the soft opening of the Seminole Theater that's been dormant for over 20 years, closer to 40. And in less than 2 years, this team and staff put that together, and you were walking through it last week. That's an amazing accomplishment. You know, to the police department, we're a 105-year-old city, never had a police station built for the police. 105 years later, we're finally going to be able to do that for the police department, and that's all been done in 2 years. So a lot of the planning took place earlier, but this council stepped up, And it took the risk and stepped out and led the charge and brought the public along. So I can't say enough about this group. Larry, congratulations. Mr. Roth, congratulations. I think you're just going to melt right into this group, and it's just going to be seamless and flow so smoothly that we won't hit a bump. So congratulations to you. I know you earned this position. You earned the seat at this table. And thank you for running. Thank you. So I don't want to talk all night, but I want to thank the public for giving this group the opportunity to sit back at this table, because you'll see great things. You'll see great things. But thank you very much, everyone. Now, the most important motion of the evening is the motion to adjourn. Is there a motion to adjourn?
Move it.
Is there a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Meeting is adjourned. Thank you, everyone, for being here.